one this morning and one this afternoon that we need to remember in prayer today. Brother Rex called me before church and said he worked in the yard Thursday and his knees is killing him. So he wanted us to be praying for his knees. And Sister Werf texted me this morning, her back is killing her and she's not been able to get out of the house. Wanted us to remember her in prayer. So we open scripture, says over and over again in the Bible, especially Psalms 50 and many others, it says, call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver thee, and thou shalt glorify me. Over and over again, it tells us to call unto him, to bring our needs unto him. And tonight we've come to worship and magnify and praise him. Let us stand tonight and take these knees to the Lord in prayer and just worship and praise the Lord today. Father, Lord, we come before your presence with thanksgiving. We enter into your courts with praise, Lord. Father, Lord, you said that we can bring our needs and our requests unto you, and you will hear them and answer them, Lord. We pray for Brother Rex tonight, Lord, his knees that is bothering him, Lord. Father, Lord, he wants you to heal his knees. And, Lord, we pray right now that you give him the desires of his heart, Lord, that you would touch him, that you would minister to him. Let your complete healing power to flow through his body. Let that healing power, that healing ointment of God to flow through him, Lord. Father, Lord, we pray for Sister Werf tonight, Lord, that you would continue to let your healing power to flow through her body. You see her back that's bothering her. She can't even get out of the house, Lord. But Father, Lord, you're able to touch her and you're able to minister to her. Give her the desires of her heart and touch her and minister to her. Strengthen her that she can get out of the house of God and come back to the church and worship you, Lord. Father, Lord, we also pray for Sister Sasser tonight, Lord. We pray, Lord, that you just let your healing power to flow through her body and that you would touch her and strengthen her, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We invite you to have your way today in this service, Lord. Bless every part of the service tonight. Pour out your spirit among us, Lord. Let your anointing to fill this place. For the anointing breaks every yoke of bondage and sets the captives free, Lord. We ask that you would move among our hearts and move among our lives today, Lord. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Remain standing and let's worship and praise the Lord today.
At the cross where I first saw the light and the burden of my heart rolled away, it was there by faith that I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Must Jesus bear the cross alone and let all the world go free? No, there's a cross for everyone, and there's a cross for me. At the cross where I first saw the light and the burden of my heart rolled away, it was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. At the cross where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away, it was there by faith that I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Alas, and did my Savior bleed, and did my Sovereign die? Would he devote that sacred head for such a worm as I? At the cross where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away, it was there by faith that I received my sight, and now I am happy all the time. holiday. Was it for crimes that I had done? He groaned upon the tree. Amazing pity, grace unknown, and love beyond degree. Oh, at the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith that I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Oh, at the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart, it rolled away. It was there by faith that I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. And I believe in the cleansing blood. And I believe in the hill called Calvary, where Jesus died for you and me. And I believe that he lives, and that he's coming back again. Every knee shall bow and every tongue confess. Well, this I believe. I believe in the cross, and I believe in the cleansing blood, and I believe in the hill called Calvary, where Jesus died for you and me. And I believe that he lives, and that he's coming back again. Every knee shall bow and every tongue confess. Well, this I believe. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus that washes white. And I believe in the cross, and I believe in the cleansing blood, and I believe in the hill called Calvary, where Jesus died for you and me. And I believe that he lives, and that he's coming back again. Every knee shall bow and every tongue confess. Well, this I believe. There's power in the blood of Jesus. There's power in the blood of Jesus. There's power in the blood of that washes white as snow.
Salvation in the blood
of Jesus. Salvation in the blood of Jesus. Salvation in the blood of Jesus that washes white as snow. And I believe in the cross, and I believe in the cleansing blood, and I believe in the hill called Calvary, where Jesus died for you and me. And I believe that he lives, and that he's coming back again. Every knee shall bow and every tongue confess. Well, this I believe.
my reward and all of my devotion. Now there's nothing in this world that could ever satisfy. Through every trial, my soul will sing, no turning back, I've been set free. Christ is enough for me, oh Christ is enough for me. Everything I need is in you, everything I need. Christ my all and all, the joy of my salvation. And this hope will never fail, heaven is our home. Storm, my soul will sing, Jesus is here, to God be the glory. Christ is enough for me, Christ is enough for me, and everything I need is in you, and everything I need. I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back. The cross before me, the world behind me, no turning back, no turning back. The cross before me, the world behind me, no turning back, no turning back. Christ is enough for me, Christ is enough for me. Everything I need is in you, and everything I need. Christ is enough for me, Christ is enough for me. And everything I need is in you, and everything I need. I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back. The cross before me, the world behind me, no turning back, no turning back. The cross before me, the world behind me, no turning back, no turning back. Christ is enough for me, Christ is enough for me. Everything I need is in you, everything I need.
Christ is enough for me, oh Christ is enough for me.
Everything I need is in you,
everything I need.
Oh, if you believe that tonight, say amen. Amen. He truly is our everything. For that, we are grateful tonight. Help us fill this choir. Let's continue to worship the Lord in song tonight. page 120 if you need a book in front of you there up on the screen. I'm so thankful that we have victory in Jesus tonight. Can somebody say amen? Amen. Miss Brother Roger and Sister Jane, they're out of town this weekend. He usually leads our choir, but when he's gone, I get to, and I'm thankful for that as well. Amen. Let's sing it. Victory in Jesus.
Blood. I heard about a mansion he has built for me in glory, and heard about the streets of gold beyond the crystal sea, about the angels singing and the old redemption story, and some sweet day I'll sing up there. Aren't you thankful for that tonight? Sing it now. I heard an old, old story, how the Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning, of his precious blood's atoning. Then I repented of my sins and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me.
Amen. I'm glad for victory in Jesus tonight. Amen. What can wash away our sins? Nothing but the blood of the Lamb. This afternoon we were at the house, and briefly I was just asking Sister Wendy, I said, what are you singing tonight for worship? I don't always know what she has lined up. She picks those out, you know, and she talks to the Lord about that, and I talked to the Lord about the messages, and she said, I'm going to sing about at the cross tonight. Now, if you were here this morning, I preached about that cross, and it's amazing how God just puts all that together, and I was rejoicing in my spirit about what the Lord has done around this place, and I'm thankful for Calvary. I know Calvary is gruesome. I know Calvary is ugly. Calvary was bloodful, full of blood, full of pain, full of agony, but I'm thankful for Calvary tonight. Amen. Without it, we would not be where we are in the Lord, and I'm so grateful for that. So good to see you in the house of the Lord tonight, and I'm just expecting great things to happen in this place tonight. Don't forget about the announcements. Tomorrow night at 7 o'clock will be our leadership meeting. Wednesday night will be Wednesday night meals at 6 and church, clubs, and classes, all that at 7. And then this coming weekend, Friday night, the young adults have an event on Friday night, and then youth choir practice on Saturday night. So looking forward to what God is doing in our church. And what a joy it is to have Dr. Hong Yang and Sister Esther. Would you welcome them now? We'll introduce them again later. But so glad to have you guys with us again tonight.
We were looking back. It was 3 years ago, almost exactly 3 years ago, July in 2014. And so it's been a long time, and we're delighted that they're here. And you'll hear more from him later on in this service tonight. We're going to receive two offerings tonight. We're going to receive our general offering at this time. That'll be for our tithes and our general offerings. And then when Dr. Hong Yang comes, he'll preach to you, talk to you about missions, and testify. He'll do a little bit of all of it tonight. Amen. And then at the end of service, we will allow you another opportunity to give specifically to his project, and he'll talk to us more about that. And we responded real well to that last time he was here, and I know we'll do that again tonight. But this first offering will be our general Sunday night offering to go toward the expenses of our church and the ministry. So ushers, if you would come at this time and get ready to wait upon the congregation, thank you for how you responded this morning. And just so thankful that we're part of the family of God and all that God is doing amongst us. Let us pray tonight. Father, we thank you for the cause of Christ. Thank you for the blood of the Lamb that still brings victory. Thank you for the privilege that we have to be in your house tonight. I pray that you'll bless the gift and the giver. Multiply it for the intended use. God, let us give with a cheerful heart. We'll forever be thankful for how you use it for your kingdom. In the name of Jesus, we pray. And everybody said amen and amen. God bless you as you give tonight.
Amen. Praise the Lord. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. Yes, he is. Amen. Worship the Lord as our special music, Kyle sings, and then the youth choir is going to come.
I'm thankful for his presence tonight.
Fill the air. Glory, God, is what our hearts long for. star on the sun. Those big stars that hang in us, and just more miracles he's done. His breath becomes the wind, the sea, and the pomp of his majesty. Tell me who but God can do such things as these.
Well, tell me who but God can do such things as these. Who but God can do such things as these. He can calm the stormy waters when he sends his sleep. Only who but God can do such things as these. Well, tell me who but God can do such things as these. Who but God can do such things as these. He can calm the stormy waters. He can change a life so that you ruin the world, set them no hope. Cause a drunkard to the drink and set an addict free from dope. He can change something from nothing, cause he did it just for me. Tell me who but God can do such things as these. Well, tell me who but God can do such things as these. Who but God can do such things as these.
Situation in your life right now. Who but God? I was thinking about it before church this morning. I had a who but God situation almost a year ago, next month, where my heart was acting up. It was going crazy. I thought I was going to die. I go to the doctor. He says, you're going to wear a heart monitor for 3 days. I was like, Lord Jesus, help me. I don't want to wear that thing. I wore it for 3 days. Not one single thing happened, because the night before I was prayed for right down here in this altar. Who but God can do that? No doctor, No medicine can do that. Who but God? The night we moved here, Colton had a migraine. It's one of the worst I've ever seen him have. He couldn't stay still. He was crying, and that's not like him. But his daddy said, let's pray for him. We went in there. We prayed for him. Within seconds, he had went to sleep. Now, who but God can do that? No ibuprofen or Tylenol can do that tonight. Hallelujah. I'm so thankful that he's faithful in our life. Titus, sing that second verse again. Hallelujah.
You can change your life so that you win the world, says there's no hope. Come on, look at the truth, and you can set it out if you want to. You can't change something for nothing, cause he did it just for me. Tell me who but God can use the same as me. Well, tell me who but God can use the same as me. Who but God can use the same as me. You can call the stormy waters.
But God can do some of the things that's happened in our life. Amen. So thankful for that tonight. Again, what a joy it is to have Dr. Hong Yang and Sister Esther with us tonight, and we're going to turn this service right over to him. How many of you have never heard Dr. Hong Yang before? This will be your first time. You are in for a treat. That means we don't know where you were at 3 years ago, but you weren't here. Amen. And so we've got some brand new folks that will be introduced to Dr. Hong Yang tonight, and we're so thankful for his friendship. We were just reminiscing briefly. Wendy's brother went out of country with him, Brother and Sister Dillard, Brother and Sister Hanks, and all of those things. So he is among friends and among family tonight. Would you welcome Dr. and Sister Dr. and Esther Hong Yang as they come tonight?
Praise the Lord. How many can say praise the Lord? Put your hand together. Let's really praise the Lord. Give the Lord. heard a great and mighty applause, for he alone is worthy, worthy. Lift him up and lift him higher and higher and higher. Amen. Because Jesus said, this is the key verse for all of us, John 12:32. Jesus said, if I am lifted up, exalted, I will draw all men unto me. Amen. We are here to lift up the name of Jesus in glory, in majesty, in power, in authority, and in praises, because the Lord inhabits the praises of his people, and we are his people. One more time, let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise, praise, and be thankful unto him, and bless his holy name. Why? Psalm 100, last verse tells us why. Why? Because the Lord God, he is good. And he is good all the time. And all the time he is good. And he is good no matter what. And no matter what, he is good. Amen. Praise God. For his mercy is everlasting. And his truth endures to A-L-L, all generations. Because of A-L-L, all generations, therefore let us make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye people. Amen. Psalm 100 starts with A-L-L, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye people, ending with A-L-L, for his truth endure to all generations. It's wonderful. I love the word A-L-L. Amen. I'm going to read a passage with you that has six A-L-Ls in just a few verses. In fact, half a verse has three of them. I have become all things to all men, that by all means. Amen. Let's turn to the Word of God in 1 Corinthians chapter 9. As I'm thinking about it, let's read the Word of God first, because the most important thing is to focus on the Word of God, because the Word of God is Jesus Christ made flesh. For the Word, John chapter 1 verse 14 says what? For the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld. When you are reading his word, you are beholding Jesus Christ's glory. Amen. We beheld his glory. Whose glory? The glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and the truth. John 1:17 says, for the law was given through Moses, but grace and the truth came through the only begotten of the Father, whose name is Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's stand, amen, and read the Word of God with great humility and with great reverence, because the Lord has done mighty great things for us. Amen. And this is reading from my New King James Version that I have in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 19 through 23. I call it reaching the lost at all cost. Reaching the lost at all cost. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. For though I am free from all men, I have made myself a servant to all, that I might win the more the merrier. And to the Jews I became as a Jew, that I might win the Jews. To those who are under the law, as under the law, that I might win those who are under the law. To those who are without the law, as without the law, even though I'm not without the law of God, but under the law towards Christ, that I might win those who are without the law. To the weak, I became as weak, that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all men, that by all means save some. And from another version I read, even the last verse, said, all this I do, or I do all this, for the sake of not my ego, my logo, or my title. No label, no title, no ego. Only Christ, Jesus. Amen. I do this for the gospel. Amen. For the sake of the gospel, that I might become partaker of it with you. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. With you. That's what we're here for. Enlisting kingdom workers from you so that we can be partakers with each other. Amen. Recruiting and enlisting, because Jesus said in Matthew chapter 9 verse 36, for the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore, because he saw the people harassed and scattered like sheep, having no pastor, no shepherd. You see, so I want to share with you this passage from my heart. It's a passion for missions. Four reasons for a missions passion. I will tell you what it means in terms of a call, a command from above, a cry from beneath, a call from without, and this passage then a conviction
from within. I'll tell you, the Great Commission, the voice of the Great Commission from four different directions, ending with this passage, is a conviction from within. It's a call from without. It's a command from above, but it also a sure cry from beneath. Luke 16, the rich man and the Lazarus. In Hades, meaning hell, he cried out several cries. But before that, I believe Ms. Rebecca and our assistant there could show us a China DVD, the Underground Church, and then I will let you hear from my better half, because I'm banned from China, as you know, probably 3 years ago, cannot get a visa. But the devil is an evil devil. Look at the word devil. Take out the word D. What do you have? Evil. The devil is evil, right? But he is also not only evil devil, he's a dumb devil. Amen. Hallelujah. He's a dumb devil. Praise the Lord for that. Amen. And he has opened the door of China. He thought he could stop me, but he could stop Hong Yang physically from going. And he could not stop the Holy Spirit from moving in China and reaching thousands upon thousands, and 30,000 a day come to Jesus Christ. And today, all my wife family, about 50, on my side, 29, are all saved, sanctified, and filled by the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. And 11 full-time ministers, some of them are even missionaries overseas. My brother, whom some of you met, my brother, he was preaching all over Japan, even last week, praise God. God is using him all over. He's been arrested and thrown in jail several times. And yet, not only are not able to go to China, but they couldn't stop the Holy Spirit working, but God has opened, when the door of man was shut, the windows of heaven were opened to me. And just this year alone, by December 17th, coming from the last mission trip, out of the 8 mission trip this year, I will have reached, by December 17th, coming back from Bulgaria, Macedonia, Israel, 20 new nations to preach the gospel and win souls and teaching the word to make disciples, about 100 nations by the end of this year. Hallelujah. Amen. I got a powerful DVD to show you in Africa when my turn comes, but I want you to hear from my better half, my childhood sweetheart, and God being faithful, and we were boy and girlfriend, secret ones, you know, because it was against the Chinese tradition, dating secret, middle school, high school, and then got married the moment we came out of college, 1985, and Tuesday, August 22, as you know, it will be our 32nd year of faithfulness and anniversary. Praise the Lord. Let's see this. Then Esther will come and share with you, because she just came back from China. Amen.
Few places in the world are seeing the explosion of God's power like the underground church in China is experiencing. And in the last 60 years, China's communist government has done its best to wipe Christianity off the map. What you are about to see is some of the rarest footage on the planet. In this church, the people wake up at 4:30 to come together for 2 hours to pray and worship. They do this every day. This church meets in the only place they're safe, a cave. This church meets on a farm, far away from prying eyes. Here's an example of an underground church outreach. The people sitting are Christians. The people who are standing are not. This particular preacher was once crippled, but was healed when someone prayed for her. She now preaches the good news of Jesus to anyone who will listen. In this particular meeting, over 1,000 people became Christians. Here, Christians cast out demons from an 18-year-old girl. She's now a preacher. In Shanghai alone, there are over 3,000 house churches, just like this one. One thing Dennis pointed out to me was that most of the underground churches in China are actually led by young people. These kids have all come out of the communist system, and they want nothing to do with it. They only want to spread the love of Jesus to everybody they meet. This is a music school. Well, that's the cover anyway. It's really a training school for students who want to be pastors. The government thinks they're simply learning to play instruments. One thing I quickly realized about the Chinese church is that it's a lot different from the American one. For one thing, they think a 4-hour sermon is short. In this church service, it's 120 degrees inside the building. The people meet for 12 hours straight. Dennis told me one story about a time he went to a very remote village in China to preach. He was led into a large room where the people were packed so closely together that he had his back to the wall and could reach out and touch the row in front of him. Everyone stood. There was no room to sit. He asked how long he should preach for, and they told him from 8:30 to 7 at night. Then they asked him, if it wasn't too much trouble, could you come back tomorrow and preach from 8:30 to 7 again? And then, very sheepishly, they asked again, if you'd be so kind, could you come back the day after that and preach from 8:30 to 7? He asked how often he should take breaks, and they told him not to stop. The people will wait. Then he asked them what he should preach on. Everything, they replied, from Genesis to Revelation. And then it dawned on him, these people had no Bibles.
After the death of Mao Zedong, the Chinese people, cheated by a false god, began to search for the true God. For the first time in their lives, people from the lowest levels of society came face to face with God's unconditional love, with Christ's sacrifice on the cross, and with the knowledge that in God's temple they had value and dignity. How could they not rejoice, like everyone who has received the most precious gift in the world?
The first time I went to church, I felt the atmosphere there was really good. I found true meaning in life.
Hallelujah, praise the Lord.
I found peace that I never felt before. Peace in the Lord. So I can sit without reservation.
We can stop here because this video is quite long or not yet. Okay, it's fine. And it is wonderful. Praise the Lord. Amen. And praise the Lord. Let's just praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. And it is wonderful to be in the house of the Lord. It is wonderful to sing songs of praise every single time. When we are set, when we are done, when we are tired, it's time for us to start praising. When our praises go up, the presence of the Lord will descend down. In the presence of God Almighty, there is the fullness of joy. The joy of the Lord will become our strength. Hallelujah. So every time we feel sad, hey, start a song of praise. And you will feel the energy and you will feel the strength. And so when our praises go up, the power, the presence of the Lord will descend down every single time when we begin to pray to the Lord. Jesus, when two or three gather together in my name, and whatever you ask, it shall be done unto you. And there is power in prayer. So when our prayers go up, and the power of the Lord will descend down, and whatever you ask, it shall be done unto you. And so we need your prayers, and we need the praises together with God's people. And when the God descend down from the heavens above, and in the presence of God Almighty, everything began to happen. And just one touch with his finger, your body will never be the same anymore. Hallelujah! And your spirit will never be the same anymore. And your heart filled with joy, with gladness, and your body got healed, and your joy was with gladness, and with peace, and with his love, and just filled our hearts. And you have seen these brief videos, and you'll see they even sing a song of praise. And you can see something very, very different among the Chinese worship and American worship. And I love music. And I love your youth choir. Hallelujah. Amen. And so you just see, you can feel the power of praise and going up. And whichever way, and whether with music, with instrument or without instrument, and when the praises go up, you can see something different. It's very different when we begin to pray at home, then when two or three gather together, when we incorporate the prayers, and there is a great difference. Why? Because the more people begin to pray in unison, in one accord, you can feel the strong presence, the strong anointing of the Holy Spirit. And so it's wonderful when people of the Lord gather together. Nothing can replace it. When God's people gather together, that's why we shall not ever forsake assembling ourselves together in the name of Jesus. Amen. And so today I want to also sing a song of praise with all of you. Have you have a little bit of taste how the Chinese house churches worship in China? You'll see the video, and a picture is worth 1,000 words. But I want you to have a little bit of taste, experience. That's my saying. Experience is worth 10,000 pictures. Amen. And so today I'm going to sing a song. It's called More. More. Children of God. It said, children of God, let's praise more, let's pray more, let's read his words more, and let's seek his face more. And oh Lord, we wait upon you for your people, and you will not forsake, even though the enemies may attack. But let's trust more in Jesus and do more of his work. In the name of Jesus, let's go out to share his good news. In the name of Jesus, let's go out to heal various diseases. In the name of Jesus, let's go out to cast out demons. And fear not, be strong and courageous. Let's follow Jesus to the heavens. So it is a wonderful praise song, and full of energy and full of mission. So I am today going to sing in Chinese. Anybody who knows Chinese, you are more than welcome to sing with me in Chinese. And even if you don't know any Chinese, you can still sing it with me, with your hand, with your heart, and also with your spirit. Therefore, let's stand up and put our hand together and praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen.
多起起道多个生三的儿女
Hallelujah! Let's follow Jesus to the heavens. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! you maybe say that. And it is wonderful to follow Jesus to the heavens. And this is a very important thing. It is a very important thing that Jesus, 2,000 years ago, he did on earth. And one day I was asking the Lord, Lord, what should be the most important thing in my life and in the ministries? And the Lord revealed to me, so he said, just do the same thing that I did. So I look at the Bible and turn to Matthew chapter 9. And this is what it says, especially from verse 35, is that Jesus went about all the cities and the villages and preaching in their synagogues and teaching in their synagogues and preaching the kingdom of heaven. Amen. Hallelujah. And he was healing very kind of diseases among the people. When he saw the multitude, he was filled with compassion because they were harassed. They were worried like sheep without shepherds. And then he said to his disciples, the harvest is truly plentiful, but the laborers are few. Pray therefore that the Lord of the harvest will send laborers into his harvest field. And this is the heart of compassion of our Lord Jesus. First, he went everywhere, all the cities and all the villages, and doing three specific things. He was teaching in the synagogues and preaching the kingdom of heaven. The number one thing in the teaching and preaching of Jesus Christ is about the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. This is the number one primary teaching of Jesus. Is then the second thing, not only preaching and teaching, and he was doing something. What did he do? He was casting out demons, and he was healing all kind of very kind of diseases among the people. This is the very thing that Jesus is in laying very heavy in his heart. He did it himself. If you flip the page in the next chapter, and chapter Matthew 10, and also in Luke chapter 9, is almost similar. It said Jesus, he appointed, selected 12 of his disciples, and gave them the power and authority to go out to preach the gospel and the kingdom of heaven, and give them the power and authority over the darkness and over the dominion of the enemy, and to deliver people from different diseases and cast out demons. And he gave them power, let them, the 12 disciples did the same thing. And then the 12 disciples is not enough. So in Luke chapter 10, and it said Jesus appointed or selected 70 of his disciples and gave them the same thing instruction as he gave the 12 disciples, and sent to the place that he himself was about to go. And he taught them in details. When people accept what you shall do, when people don't accept what you shall do, what should be your attitude? I have given you the authority and power, so you go and do the same thing. Preach the gospel, tell them about the kingdom of God is at hand, heal different diseases, and cast out demons. And even among the ministries of Apostle Paul, and he said, declare himself in 1 Corinthians, hey, I come to you, and not with the persuasion or the wisdom of this world, but I have come to you with the demonstration of the Holy Spirit and of power. What is the demonstration of the Holy Spirit and of power? Of course, talk is cheap. Show me something. Man, you can see when Apostle Paul and when Jesus Christ, when the disciples, and when they lay their hand on the people, people are healed. When they lay hand on the people and rebuke the devil fled, and the devil flee, and from their presence, and the people were set free. And you can see it was so important in the ministries of Jesus, and Jesus already told all of us before he ascended to heaven, our power already given to you, so when the Holy Spirit come upon you, you shall receive power. And you shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea, in all Samaria, until the ends of the world, until the ends of the earth. And so he gave us all the same thing, commission, and the great commission, and go and tell, and go in my name. And you can see, and even the 70 people, the 70 disciples, they got so excited. I am very, very excited. If I lay hand on someone who is sick, they get healed, are you not going to get excited? Absolutely, I will be excited. And so when we pray in the name of Jesus, there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the blood of the Lamb. So when we go there to cast out demons, and the demon left that person, you can imagine the excitement. And when you are sick, hey, if you don't believe it, when you are sick, and pray and trust the Lord and see whether he's going to work for you or not. And when you touch a little finger from God and touch your, just touch your body, you will completely get healed. You got so excited. Right. And the people who are praying for you, they got excited. Yeah. Amen. Right. And so you can imagine the excitement among the disciples, especially the 70, after they have followed the example of Jesus and followed the command of Jesus, they went out. They began to preach the kingdom of God, and they began to heal different diseases. They began to cast out demons. When they got back, they were filled with joy. They began to report to Jesus, "Oh Lord, even the Satan, even the devil, even the spirits are subject to us in your name." And so they were so excited, and they were so happy. And what did Jesus say to all of them? And Jesus said, I saw Satan fall like lightning, and you were so happy, but do not rejoice, because the spirits are subject to you, because I have given you authority and power to trample upon the snakes and the scorpions and all the powers of the enemy. They cannot do you any harm. And they just because they listen to you, because it was done in my name, and you are so happy, and don't just rejoice in this. And you guys got yours, because from now on, your names are written in heaven. We got to rejoice when we follow the command of Jesus. Our names will be written in heaven. And it's when we obey the command of the Lord, and when we go out to do the ministries, and for sure you will know, and you will encounter, this is a power encounter, this is a spirit encounter, and this is a God encounter. And when we do the things that Jesus commanded us to do, and for sure, you can be for sure and forever, and knowing that our names will be written in heaven. Why? Because Jesus Christ promised us so. And so you can see this great endeavor every single time when we go out to do the ministries. And knowing all of this, and I want to thank all of you, because you are part of this ministry also. And wherever we go, whether it's in China, or Latin America, or is in Asia, or is in Africa, every time we go to the mission field, there is going to have a power encounter. And so people's lives get changed, and the demons flee, people being set free. Just we were just like, even in the United States of America, recently, like in May, and we have some friends came from China, and we've been friends for them for years. We've been trying to witness to them, but they were kind of like a diehard communists, and they were leaders of the communist party and of the different business and stuff. Their daughter was graduating from Lee University, and she got saved. She was a lot of times, you know, you got to work inside out and outside in. And so we began to witness. So say they came for their daughter's graduation. As well, they were came to for their daughter's graduation, their her parents and her grandmother, and they stayed in our home. It is a wonderful time to have fellowship and witness. And so every single day, you know, we began to share about different kind of things and stuff until one final day we said, okay, now, you know, you have seen quite a lot, and now I want to share something that is very, very important. And not only in my life, I believe also going to be very important in all of your lives. You know, our Chinese, we are from the Chinese background, and we all know, and from the, we've been believing in this for 5,000 years, and this kind of belief is almost engraved into our Chinese bones. And you know, and I know, and we all believe when we die, we will go to hell straight. And this is the Chinese belief, every Chinese belief, 5,000 years. And so we know in hell will be 18 layers, and depends how we behave in this world. If we have been a good person, we'll be sentenced to the upper layer of hell. And if we have been a very wicked person, we will be ending up in the bottom layer of hell, which is the 18th layer. And we all know in the 18th layer of hell, and there will be a huge hot boiling oil pot. In American way, it will be almost, you'll be deep fried like the Kentucky Fried Chicken. And I began to say, you also know that every time when someone passed away, and at the funeral, right in front of the coffin, right in front of the grave, and even our Chinese New Year Day, we all do this to burn paper money for the dead. Well, the hell bank note in front of the coffin. In America, we got even the advanced version in Chinatown, in the grocery stores, among the Chinese grocery stores, they have this advanced. If you could Google it later, the hell bank note, it will show you the even the advanced $10,000 hell bank note. And so people burn in front of the coffin and believe once this paper money was burned, and your loved ones who passed away on the other side will receive this money and use this money to bribe the devils and demons in hell to lessen their torments. And I began to share the gospel, you know, and this is what we believe. And there is no way out. Nobody is good enough to climb up to heaven, and because there is absolutely no way on earth. But I want to share something that is very, very different and from everything you have ever heard about, and about Jesus. And because God loved us so much, and God made a way for all of us, and he is the way from heaven descending down on earth, made a way for us from heaven above down to earth. But not only so, he died on the cross, and he paid our debt with his blood in hell, and our debt was paid. And not only he went to hell on our behalf, but also he resurrected from the grave and then returned back to heaven where he came from. And he made a way from heaven down to earth, and then lead us away from earth to the glory. And so the only way that we can get out of hell is by believing and follow that this God called Jesus Christ. So today, I am setting before you two ways, blessings and curses, life and death, and heaven and hell. You choose which one do you want in your own life. Do you want to choose less? Do you want to choose death, curse, and hell? Or you want to choose life, blessings, and heaven? And she said, of course, I want to choose life and blessings and heaven. And so we said, okay, that's wonderful. Since you have the desire, want to choose life and blessing, the only way that you can have it is by confess with your mouth about the Lordship of Jesus Christ, but also believe in your heart he have risen from the grave. And you, by confession of your mouth and believe in your heart, you will be saved. And right there, Okay, and we have all three of them together, and along with my husband, and we said, okay, we're going to pray for you. Okay, if you want to choose life and blessings in heaven, and this is the only way you can do it, because there's no any other name in heaven and on earth and under the earth except the name of Jesus. And there's no any other name is given except Jesus Christ. So therefore, we are going to give you two prayers. The first prayer is prayer of confession. Whatever I say, you follow me. And so both Hong and I, we began to lead them in the Lord. And after we led them to the Lord and have the word of confession, then the second prayer, we want to pray a prayer of blessings upon all your lives. And so they received the prayer and the tears just rolling down from their eyes. And we began to sing the songs of worship. They could not stop praying. So every single time when you are in trouble, start praising God, sing songs of praise. And we can teach you the Chinese song, praise song, and even give you hymnals. And you know music, you can go back home and play. We can give you a Bible. You can read the word and you will be strong. And you will be greatly encouraged. And every time you have trouble, you can pray to this Almighty God, and He will carry all your worries, and He will bear all your burdens. And the tears just rolling down from their eyes, and they began to say, they have never felt anything like this. We said, oh, it is the presence of God, and it is the anointing of the Holy Spirit, and it is right in the presence of the mercy and the throne of the Lord Jesus Christ. And so the heart was mended, the spirit was healed, and their soul was restored. And that is the power of the name of Jesus. That is the power of the blood of the Lamb. And I do thank all of you for being part of all this great work among the people around the world. May the Lord continue use all of you, and please continue pray for us and join us as part of these great ministries. Wherever we go, you are going with us. Wherever, whosoever that we touch, you are touching together with us. We might be the hand working in the field, but you are the arm behind the hand. Without the strength of the hand, without the strength of the arm, there is no power in the hand. So when the prayers go up, the power of the Lord will come down. Let's continue to do mighty works for the advancement of God's kingdom. And the Lord bless you. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Okay, the second video. Okay, we're going to see the second video about Africa. And where we're going to be in September, in 6th, about 2 weeks from now. Yeah, let's see this was a PowerPoint.
Yeah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And thank you, Jesus. Amen. Now you see why I'm excited. My wife excited to go in 2 weeks preaching the gospel in the first few days of September. Come back 26. Over 3 weeks ministering there. And starting from South Africa, we've been ministering several times. And then Botswana, hopefully Malawi. And 80-hour teaching alone in the Leopard Hill of the Church of God Bible Training Center in Lusaka, Zambia. And then preaching crusades evenings and the churches. And besides teaching on the master level, students from 15 nations, many from the northern Muslim country of Africa, for 80 hours. Praise God. You pray for us. And you are part of this by being prayer warriors. And in partnership with us in our missions, besides Bible for China. You heard from the end of the other video. And then Pastor Balcom suddenly found out, Pastor Dennis Balcom found out that these people don't have Bibles. One Bible for 40,000 Chinese people. Average in America is one person, four Bible. In China is one Bible for 40,000 people. Go figure this, you know? So Okoye may have Bible or two hiding somewhere secretly, because if they catch you, you are in big trouble. When we grew up, we did not know, but of course we knew secret Christian. Later we found out, execution. Just like they do in Muslim countries, beheading. Two of our missionaries just got beheaded in Pakistan, missionary from China. 24-year-old wife and 26-year-old husband. And 10 of our missionaries from China, Shanghai area, are missing even in Pakistan. So you pray. This is this, you can Google and find out instantly. You know, it's because they are beginning to send out missionaries, and you are part of this. We have Church of God. We did not have any church or any minister except that went back to China. But starting from 1998, started building underground churches. A few of you have been, and I hope Pastor Odom will go bring a team with you. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Now listen, now we have over 4,000 ministers and hundreds and thousands of churches all over the places. And in many places, they are raising mission support and sending missionaries to North Korea, India, Thailand, and even Pakistan and the Philippines. Give the Lord a praise for that. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. And that's what we'll be doing. Evening crusades, ladies conference, they got thousands coming, women in missions, amen. And I've been doing Botswana, and just awesome. You need to come. And we did it, we all even did it in Morocco, Mali, dangerous, and Senegal, dangerous, and Niger, even more dangerous. But if you really want to experience the danger, Mauritania, Libya, Somalia, and Eritrea is like North Korea of Africa. Eritrea, Eritrea. It's a small country separated from Ethiopia. Church of God in Ethiopia growing powerful, strong. Amen. And we have center Addis Ababa. But this is a piece north, separated from Ethiopia, became what you know as Eritrea. Eritrea. I got it right. 100, and all these other I mentioned, just for praying over your meal. Okay, where do you get your meal? Your bread, your food. From Muslim places, because 100% Islam. If they catch you even praying over your meal, your own private business, you'll be beheaded. This is how severe it is. Like North Korea, Eritrea, probably the worst of all. This is worse even than some part of the Middle East. So please pray for us. Amen. And I want to share with you four missions, reasons for missions. And I already give you a little outline. Amen. This is more of a little brief teaching session, but inspire you with the two DVDs so that you will know how you are helping us with prayers and how to pray also, and where your support will go. Bible and underground Bible schools. $1 a day makes a difference. I call it DDD, Pastor. Dollar day difference. Sister Wendy. Amen. DDD. Not the devil, demons, and diseases. Amen. Amen. This is a dollar day difference, because these underground Bible school students come and see this. You know, they live on a dollar a day, which means for $30, you can support one student. For $10, you can make available two Bibles. It's just awesome. African students, this is on the master level, and we raise $1,000 that lasts them 1 year. Here, $1,000, you can't even cover half of a one course. You know, go to Lee University, it's like $1,800 or $2,000 for one class of 3 hours. You all know that.
So you can pray and invest in this. I'm still having one more week to go to a fundraise, and before we go early few days of September, please pray for us. And you have a chance, and now you are, you know, you can pray with us. Pray in the spirit and pray with understanding. Amen. And this is, you can give in the spirit and give with understanding, and 100% of what you give is the tax deductible, and 100% will go to the mission project for which you give. Amen. First and foremost, why the Great Commission? Jesus emphasized the Great Commission 5 times. Let me give you a brief review. 5 times. Why 5 times? Why so frequent? Because it's important. What is important is frequent, and what is frequent is important. Remember that. That's why I don't get into some little obscure corners and then try to dig out a lot of truth from an obscure verse. Sometimes it can be very dangerous because it can be out of context. A text out of context becomes a pretext. You know what I mean? Amen. So remember that. So what is frequent is important. What is clear is important. What is important is clear. How do you make it clear? Through frequency of emphasis. Amen. Not for redundancy, but for stressing the importance of it. Repetition. The best way to remember is repetition, you know? That's why we go to ministry in Israel. You see the Jews just like this in the Western world and in their Bible seminaries, memorizing scripture, repetition, you know. And I memorize scripture. My wife does also through constant, frequent use, but also intentional repetition when your mind is the clearest. For me, it's always early in the morning. For my wife, it's always midnight, I hate to say. Her mind will come extremely clear after 10:30 p.m., you know, somehow. Now you see. But anyway, first of all, we carry out the Great Commission. First reason, the 4 reasons you heard outline, is because we have a command from above. A command from above is because Jesus risen from the dead. This was after he was risen from the dead. That means he was above death, above the grave, above Satan, above the devil. He has won us the victory, and through him we will have the victory, because anyone who is born of God shall overcome this world, and this is the victory that has already overcome the world, even our faith. 1 John 5:4. Amen. And 1 John 4:4 says, because greater is he who lives in you and me than he that is of the devil of this world. Amen. First of all, command from above, from the 5 times the Great Commission is given. First, Matthew 28:18-20. In 3 verses, 4 ALLs. All authority has been given unto you. Go ye into all the Pante Ethne, all the ethnicities. Teach them to observe all things, and I'll be with you always. Amen. Besides baptism and disciples and converts. You know, this includes ALL 4 times in the Great Commission, as ALL was used 4 times, even in the Great Commandment, Mark 12:30. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your mind, all your soul, and all your strength. And then and only then can you love others as yourself. Jesus does not want to overemphasize as yourself, because most of us love ourselves a little too much, you know. Amen. He wants to de-emphasize that, you know. Amen. But praise God. So command from above, Matthew 28, then Mark 16:15. Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation. And then Luke 24:47. This message of repentance and remission of sin shall be preached in my name, starting unto all the world, but starting from your own Okoye. Jerusalem, right? Amen. Starting here, starting now, starting with me, starting small. Amen. That is the law of the process. And that Matthew, Mark, Luke, John 20:21. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. And he breathed upon them the Holy Spirit and said, go. Go and do likewise. Go quickly and tell. Matthew 28:7. Go quickly and tell. Immediacy and urgency. And I read a proverb that says, the wise does at once what the fool does at last. Whoa, that's pretty good. The wise does at once what the fool had to do at last, when he could not, you know, procrastinate any longer. That's what happened to those kingdom workers in Matthew 25. It says, when they received their talents, they didn't fear, they didn't worry, they didn't hide, they didn't complain, they didn't criticize. Said, at once they put their money to work, and out of 5 talents, they made another 5. Out of 2 talents, they made 2. Well done, thy good and faithful servant. Enter ye into the joy of the Lord. Wow. At once. Praise God. Amen. Jesus inviting them to come to banquet. They had all kinds of excuses. Just married, just bought land, just the father about to die, couldn't follow you. Jesus said, forget them. Go to the highways and hedges and byway and compel them. And at once, go quickly. Go quickly, he says. Go quickly and get them, you know. Praise God. So Matthew, Mark, that's Luke, right? John 20, 21. And then finally, the famous Pentecostal verse. If you can get hold of that one verse, you'll have the whole book of Acts. That's Acts 1:8. Ye shall receive power when the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and ye shall become witnesses for me, Jesus said, in Jerusalem, in all Judea, in Samaria, even unto the ends of the earth. Five times, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, and Acts 1:8. So that is a command from above. It's all given after Jesus was risen from the dead. Praise God. Second one is what I told you. It's not just a command from above. Why Great Commission? Why Passion for Mission? A command from above with all the five reasons, five times. But also, it's a cry from beneath. I wish I had time to share with you the seven cries of the Great Commission from the opposite direction. Oh man, you couldn't believe how this man in hell cried out some water, cried out to go to the other side, cried out for God's mercy, cried out for all kinds of other things, cried out he wished this, he wished that, but too little and too late. There was a point of no return. Amen. There was a point of no return. But his last wish was very interesting. Father Abraham, which is a type of God, right? Please send somebody like Lazarus who is alive and well in your bosom and let him go to my father's house because I have five other wicked, evil brothers that they need to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ before they end up like me in this tormented fiery place. Wow. Seven last cries of a dying man in hell. I wish I had time to tell you, but they are all where? Luke 16. The rich man and Lazarus. Study them. You will find seven cries. The seven last words of a dying man in hell. And I hope we'll never repeat the seven last words of a dying church. Because this church is not a dying church. It's alive and well in Jesus Christ. Because you love mission and you do evangelism. And you're carrying out the work of education and training disciples, Christian schools, and supporting missionaries all over. I thank God for you. Amen. Praise God. But you study that. What are the seven last words of a dying church? That does not fit Okoye Church of God. Of course, we never did it that way before. Because they refused to embrace the creative power of God. You know, that's dangerous. So a command from above, first reason. Cry from the beneath, Luke 16, second reason. Now also, you have a call from without. Third reason, we hear a call, a loud and clear call from without. Where? Acts 16. Acts 16, which is the Macedonian call. By the grace of God, we'll be ministering in Macedonia, preaching and teaching, even this December before Christmas. Amen, praise God. And Macedonian call. And you have heard us share with you the China call. Amen. And some of you still remember my testimony. How many remember my testimony? Raise your hand. Only one? Only two? Do I have a three? Yeah, only two. I had to give a little highlight of it. Amen. Praise God. But just a very brief highlight, you know. And This make it natural that you can get my book and read it even deeper. Amen. 130 some pages. Detail about the communist oppression and how they deceive us, you know. And brutal, you know. But let me finish it. The fourth reason. What is the fourth reason? A command from above, number one, is from the Lord, right? A cry from beneath, seven cries. That's from the Great Commission five times. A command from above, five times. Same thing. Cry from beneath. Seven reasons. Luke 16. Remember, in hell, he cried out, Hades. We're not very good Catholics, so I don't believe Hades is some kind of a purgatory. It has to be hell. Pure hell. Amen. Praise God. And then third, of course, is a Macedonian call. It's a call from without. The call from without, the command from above, and the cry from beneath. They have to become conviction from within. Why do I read that passage with you at the early start? Because I want to emphasize the last point is actually the most important point. Because the command from above means nothing to us until it becomes personal conviction from within. Amen? And the cry from beneath means nothing to us until we do something personally about it. Hallelujah. And the call from without, I don't care whether Macedonian call, or America call, or China call, or African call. If we don't personalize it, if we make it not our personal conviction, then it does not affect our life and our action. Wow, we know it had to become personal before you become real, amen? So the Great Commission and the internal conviction all have to come from within, and that's the fourth reason. Not just a command from above, not just a cry from beneath, not just hearing the call, clear call from without, Paul, please come and help us. You know, Acts 16, but it's also a conviction from within, which is 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 19 to 23, that we read. Paul said, though I'm free from all men, yet I made myself a bond slave, doulos in Greek, unto all. Amen. And he gave four examples. To the Jews, I became as a Jew that I might win, so that I might win the Jews. To those who are living under the law, I become one as under the law to win those who are living under the law, and to those without the law. See, being under the law is burdensome, is bad, but without the law is even worse. You know what I mean? That's the truth, you know? And I became as one as without the law, so as to win those who are without the law, even though I'm not without the law of God, but I'm under the law of Christ, which is grace. Amen. Praise God. And he said, to the weak, I become as weak as the weak, that I might win the weak. And his conclusion, as you heard from 1 Corinthians 9:22, I have become all things to all men, that by all means, save not all, some. Because ultimately, you heard my wife's testimony of this general manager family of a big hotel in China. Ultimately, it's your choice. Now his whole family is saved. They are evangelizing. My wife was with them not long ago, and they were doing training, Bible studies, and evangelism. Whole family coming to Jesus Christ. Give the Lord a praise. Hallelujah. And they are leading more and more and more and more people to Jesus. Amen. And this happened to another VIP, Chinese communist, and a general manager of a big hotel. His whole family got saved. Now, mother-in-law, who's a diehard Buddhist, and a wife are now leading preachers of the Church of God there in Beijing. Hallelujah. Winning many Buddhists and communists to Jesus Christ. So those are the four reasons of the Great Commission, all starting with C. First reason, command from above. And second is a cry from beneath. And the third is a call from without. And the fourth C is a conviction from within. It's like four C's with four different directions, right? Above, beneath, you know, cry from me. And then without and within. So I want you to remember that. And I already give you the detailed verses. They are all backed up. Many more verses. But I just give you a few selections that you could remember. But a brief testimony. That is, born and raised as an atheist and communist. Never ever heard the gospel of Jesus Christ, never heard the name of Jesus, or saw a Bible for 20 years. My wife, even longer, had to wait one more year until I was sure God saved and started sharing with her. Yeah, I was even criticized and condemned and almost alienated by my girlfriend today. Amen. I said, You're crazy. How can you talk about God? You are educated and we are atheists. Because the first doctrine of a communism is there was no God, there is no God, there never ever shall be a God. Atheism. Then beneath atheism is humanism. We and we only are the makers and masters of our own destiny. And beneath that humanism and that atheism is Darwinistic evolution Darwinism. The philosophy of the jungle and survival of the fittest. No ethics, no mercy, no morality. That's what's going on in China. I'm glad our president already suddenly realized what he was dealing with. And now let me give you a little commentary. You'll never solve the South North Korean problem without dealing with the Chinese problem. That is the fact. And it's been so for 60 some years, hasn't it? Not changed. Not changed, you know, since General Douglas MacArthur's time. If they followed allowed him to do that, would not have this problem from the very beginning. You all know what I'm talking about. But listen to this. That's especially when he was able to do it. Now, much more difficult. And listen, as a result, we grew up as atheist communists, brainwashed and deceived and intimidated every day. Young people like us, little children, I was talking about little teenagers, high school, middle school, watching miles and watch execution services. I did not know whether I showed you that video or not. Maybe later I can show you in the future, show pastor, and you can see execution of Christians. Oh, and World Mission made a brief DVD about me and one of our ministers who spent 18 years in the cesspool. Man, it's unbelievable, you know. Come and see these pictures, 24 years in prison, 13 years in jail. Oh, these friends of mine, teachers of our mentors, you know. So we grew up fearful and scared. And never heard of anything else but Mao, M-A-O, who killed more people of his own, at least 200 million Chinese, than Hitler and Stalin of Germany or Soviet Union put together. No one in history has ever killed more people than Mao Zedong, the dictator. I mean, this is unbelievable, you know, Ma. And you know, and as a result, guess what happened? We learned to obey the government like sheep under wolves, you know. And nobody dared to do that. And they have a monument for the victim of communism in Washington D.C. Guess number one country is China, communist China. Don't think just because there is some trade, it's all going to be good. We are about to be eaten alive with everything made in China. 87% of Walmart. I'm telling you the truth. I'm sick and tired of buying anything made in China, you know? And the other day I was introduced by a preacher. Now I present to you Brother Hong Yang, made in China, straight from Walmart. Oh my God, this is getting dangerous, you know? Yeah, seriously. Pastor from Georgia, you know? But listen to this. So as a result, guess what? What was always terrified, always hungry. We had nothing to eat. Where were the food, all the meat, the rice? All went to Vietnam to start new communist countries. All went to North Korea to start new communist countries. Under the order of Soviet Union, Joseph Stalin, from the evil empire that President Reagan calls the Soviet Union. And the people were starving. And many, many Christians were starved to death in the labor camps. In one Christian labor camp, out of 3,000 some preachers in this hard labor camp, arrested, put in jail, life imprisonment without parole, 2,800 died. 2,800 died of torture, starvation, execution, and those 200-300 survived had to eat human flesh, dead human flesh, after eating their leather shoes and their leather belt. This testified to us. They became our mentors past the 13-15 years. Especially when I was still able to go to China and become a new Christian. And these were the people I got to know when I became a new Christian. I'm jumping a little ahead of myself. That helped me connected to Open Doors with Brother Andrew, the premier Bible smuggling group, Open Door with Brother Andrew, Voice of the Martyrs. And in 1 year, we were young and strong. We were only 21, 22. Amen. Listen, in 1 year, we received and distributed to the glory of God successfully over 1 million copies of the Chinese Bible to the underground church. That caused millions of people to come to Jesus Christ, 1984 and 1985. Praise God. It's truly powerful, truly powerful. That's why you see why I'm going everywhere with my number one task, spreading the word, spreading the word, spreading the word. Amen? Praise God. Amen? Because it said, Matthew 24:14, and this gospel of the kingdom sounds like the word of God to me. Amen? And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached unto all the nations, and as a testimony unto all the peoples, and then and only then shall the end come. If we want to speed up the second coming of our Jesus Christ, we have to be willing to put up the work and go through all these countries and preach gospel. Let them have a choice, have the opportunity to hear and make their decision. We don't force them. That's why I become all things to all men. By all means, save some, not save all. Because ultimately, it's their choice. I have said before you, life and death, choose you this day whom you shall serve. See? Amen. Praise God. Amen. Long story short, guess what happened? I had a crisis. In the midst of all this, I got promoted. Like my father, grandfather, parents, grandparents, all atheist communists. You know, they all died, guess what? Without ever, ever even hearing the gospel of Jesus Christ. When I hear this, I feel guilt. I feel shame. Asians are more into shame, and Americans are more into guilt. It's the truth. In a Western culture, more guilt or innocence. In China, big, big, big problem in the mind and head is honor or shame. It's the truth, you know, number one for us, shame, you know. And they don't hesitate to use shame to cause you to feel something or do something. They don't mind at all, you know. Praise God, you know. And hearing everywhere, we try to alleviate and eliminate shame, you know, on people, you know. And that's why so many have become shameless. I hate to say, right or not. A little sense of shame is good, just like a little bit of healthy pressure, you know. Praise God. Listen to this. As a result, guess what? I was disappointed with the system, hungry, hungry, you begin to question about everything, don't you? You know, when you're hungry. And then, death of my mother, 38 years of age. In the midst of this, I went to college. Very hard to make it to college. One out of 150 high school graduates. Only one in my high school out of 150, three classes, each one 50 students, to make it to a school. Not even a famous school, just a regular provincial school, you know? And you didn't choose your major either. They decided for you to study according to their need because they were paying your way. You're like a cog in their machinery. I said, listen, so they said I was to study English. And great, praise God, I happen to like English and foreign languages. And when I came here, learned Greek and learned Spanish also. Yeah, now I'm working on Hebrew. Amen. Now I go to Africa so much, covering so many countries, and I found out 18 countries out of the 54 nations in the continent of Africa, 18 countries, 220 million people speak French. Guess what? I have a desire. I'm a burning desire to learn French. I'm already downloading some app, you know, to try to learn some French. Not just the French people, only 50 million in France. These are 220 million in 18 African countries, North and West Africa. So you pray that I will have the desire and be able to study, even though I'm almost 54 years old. Very different when you're from 18 or 21, you know. But long story short, guess what the Lord touched me? I got a hunger for truth. Because I was disappointed and disillusioned with the lies. The obvious lie was, you talk about material abundance in communist motherland. Socialism is the first step to communism. That's why you'll be very careful in America. People are so naive. You know what I mean? Listen, and we everything was rationed. You were caught eating a corn from the field, you were beaten to death. We saw this with our own eyes, and it happened to our family members and friends and relatives. Just the raw corn from the, because you were working. Nobody allowed to own 1 inch of land. One bullet is 3 years in prison, hard labor, and one BB gun. Young people have BB gun. One BB gun is 6 years in prison by law. I mean, can you imagine that? No Google, no Facebook, no Twitter, no Yahoo, and no Gmail in China. Bang. You know, yeah, imagine that. Somebody hiding something, right? You can feel it, you know? Long story short, I began to search for meaning when I realized all these lies, talking about abundance, yet we were starving to death. You know, and I told you, when you're hungry, you begin to question about everything, yourself especially, right? Oh, man. And I began to getting older, see the deceptions. We're living in deception and depression. When you live long enough in deception, you will be depressed. And then it causes you not just depression, desperation, and headed for destruction. That was my life in a nutshell. Deception, depression, destruction, and deprivation. And it got into stealing and pickpocketing. Why? Because it got into bad habit of drinking and smoking. Like father, like son. You know, my father was a communist official, but he had a little money and I had not. Poor student. And it got into and got caught, beaten black and blue, and thrown into the middle of the muddy pigsties and pig manures. I mean, it means I wanted to even commit suicide. I didn't want to even live anymore. I was so hateful and bitter inside. I even had my little blacklist. Maybe commit a few homicides before I would make my suicide worthwhile. Full of that. Were it not for the word of God that came to me late October 83, I would not be here. Either suicide or homicide, or most likely both. That was my life. And this happened not just to my thought, to the lives of some of my friends. Teenagers, college students, high school students have it, suicide, you know? And listen, a long story short, I was studying in college, and I was studying English, as they decided, and in English and American literature, I heard of the Bible. Charles Dickens, A Christmas Carol, John Bunyan's Pilgrim Progress, William Shakespeare's The Jew of Malta, Nathaniel Hawthorne's A Scarlet Letter, among many, many others, you know, Emily Dickinson and many other poets. Man, the more I studied them as my major, the more I was frustrated because they were quoting a book I had never even heard of, the Holy Bible, you know. So I began to look for the root of their quotation, but nowhere could I find a Bible in the bookstore or in the library. In fact, when I asked them, nobody even knew what it was. And it's even today, that's why most people, out of 1.4 billion people, the largest population in the world, guess what? 900 million have never heard of the word of Jesus Christ, never heard of the name of Jesus. So I want you to pray. This is the reality. I wish I could show you a video how they are receiving Bible, crying, weeping, crying. You can just type in your Google, Chinese receiving their own copy of the Bible for the first time. You'll see how many, you know, you'll cry and weep. It's unbelievable. And it's so real. Some of the video made by my friends when they went to the underground churches or Bible school with us to distribute Bibles. Holy smugglers of Jesus Christ. Amen. And we have taken, my wife and I, by the grace of God, over 1,300 holy smugglers of Jesus. And a few of you are among us tonight. Amen. Let's give the Lord a prayer. Hallelujah. The power. You shall know the truth. And the truth shall set you free. Set you free. And he who is free in the Son is free indeed. Amen. Praise God. And guess what happened? professor told me, only legal way for your academic studies, not for your spiritual and nothing, you know. For your study of English and American literature, you need the Bible. Go to the general secretary of the Communist Party, my boss. Last name, same, Yang, Yang, which means in Chinese, Yang, poplar tree, a poplar tree. You know, Jet Li, Bruce Lee, what does Li mean, L-I or L-E-E? Pear tree, pear tree, you know? Amen. Listen to this. You know what is the most common last name in the world? Most common, the most populous last name, Wang. Either W-A-N-G or W-O-N-G. Number one name among Chinese. Therefore, it had to be the number one among the world because China is the most populous, right? What is Wang? King. King. Everybody wants to be king or king's kid or king's granddaughter. That's the reason, you know. That's the most popular last name in the world. W-A-N-G or W-O-N-G, depending on how you write it, you know. But listen to this. And I went to my general secretary, pleaded with him, kicked me out a few times, but I was like the persistent widow from Luke 18 of the Bible. Amen. Persistent widow of the Bible. He never ever gave up. Amen. Praise God. I did not give up. I had a hunger for study. I went to him again and again, and he knew me for 3 years, 81, 82, now it's late October 83, and he finally approved me. And I learned a lesson about how to deal with difficult people. The communist leaders are very difficult people. How do you deal with difficult people? Either win them over or simply wear them out. Amen. Praise God. That's what I learned from the parable of the persistent widow. Persistence means wear them out. Amen. Praise God. And he finally, out of the kindness of his heart, knowing me being sincere and a student, always obeyed and respected him, he got me a special permission to go to something where I did not even know existed. The banned book section of the university library. Basement. And it was there, I had clean dust with special permission. To my pleasant surprise, I found a copy of the Bible, not in Chinese, not even New King James, not even the NKJV, King James English. And it was labeled as what? The label said, Western Pornographic Literature. It was in the section of Western Pornographic Literature, among the pile of different dusty old books, I found a copy of the Bible in King James English. Some battered, broken pages, but it was readable and it was still holding together. And that was the first time in 20 years I had the Bible. And I was given 2 weeks according to the permission favor, letter of favor, if I could find one. They did not know whether I could find one. They didn't know whether one existed or not, you know, being so long. They burned the Bible and they used the Bible as bathroom tissues. If they caught you with the Bible, execution style were growing up. This was serious on their mouth. Not one Bible allowed, not one church allowed, not one Christian allowed for 30 years from 1949 to 1979. After Mao died. Some of our church God missionary died there, perished there, martyred, you know. Listen to this. And in 2 weeks, out of the hunger of my heart, precious book, I read the Bible in 2 weeks. Hunger, hunger, hunger. We have a nephew, my wife was telling me, and of course I know him personally, Brother Mark. He's a powerful minister of the gospel. My wife gave him a Bible fresh from high school, and in 9 days, he finished reading the gospel of Jesus Christ and got convicted of his sin, repented, and called to the ministry, and went to Asian Seminary of the Church of God in Manila, and preaching the gospel like fire of Jesus Christ and of the Holy Spirit. Give the Lord a praise, hallelujah, for the fire. And he finished reading the Bible in 9 days, Pastor. Let the fire fall. Let the fire burn. Let the fire spread. Let the fire fall upon you. Let the fire burn in you. And then let the fire spread through you. Right. Amen. Praise God. Because true fire multiplies. Amen. True fire unifies. True fire purifies. And true fire also multiplies. Amen. Praise God. Long story short, guess what happened? I copied and copied the Bible. Because I realized my second week was coming to an end, and if I didn't do something, I may never ever be able to see anything like this anymore. Because the love of Jesus touched me, the light of the gospel touched me, and I began to feel the peace and the joy and the love and the purpose like I never knew in 20 years of my misery and a suicidal tendency. The Spirit of God just touched me. I feel sometimes I was reading and I was crying, and I could not stop crying. I didn't even know why. I started to cry and I didn't even know why. No book ever had done anything like that in my heart. And I began to feel the joy and the peace, the hatred and the darkness and the jealousy and envy all began to go away. And I found out I need to copy the Bible. When I read about Jesus and what he did, what he said on the cross, I began to cry bitterly, and I copy. And in the last two or three days before my Bible was taken away by the communists, guess what happened? I secretly copied from Genesis 1:1 to Revelation 22:21, about 300 pages from the Word of God in my notebooks. Finally, they could take away the Bible from my hand, but no demon, no devil could take away the Word of God from my heart. Hallelujah. The devil did not give it to me, and the devil can never, ever take it away from me. Give the Lord praise. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for the Word. And it's going to touch me like a seed, like a power, like a light, like bread. You know, it's like a mirror, everything, like a weapon, you know. Lamp to my feet and light to my path. Psalm 119, verse 105. Oh, man. Joy unspeakable and full of glory. I never ever experienced, and it was a peace that passed all understanding. Because many places I did not understand. Many places, even today, I would be lying to you if I said I understood everything. No, by faith. And as long as you receive by faith, when you don't understand in your head, then peace comes and a purpose comes and a power comes, amen, and a passion comes, whether you understand it with your head or not. In order for you to understand God, you need to stand under God, amen, praise God. And the Spirit of God touched me. Finally, I began to have dreams and visions. Remember, never met a Christian yet. Had the Bible for 2 weeks in 20 years. Bible was gone. All I had was what? My manuscript that I secretly copied during the last two, three days. Word of God. And I memorized a large portion of it by heart. And in our underground church and Bible schools, you saw this. You can come and see the picture. They memorized the Gospel of John and even the book of Romans. Some of them even memorized the book of Acts. They memorize, personalize, internalize, visualize, vocalize, then actualize, then they realize the power and the promise of God's word. Praise God. And that's a sequence, you know, become personal, right? Long story short, the Spirit of God began to cause me, give me dreams and visions. Do you know with dreams and visions, thousands upon thousands of Chinese have come to Jesus Christ. They didn't have the Bible. Let me tell you a secret that the devil doesn't want you to know. Among Muslims, diehard Muslim and even radical Muslims, over 1,000 Muslims a day come to Jesus Christ because of the dreams and the vision of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let's give the Lord a praise. Hallelujah. And many, many, many of them you saw on the picture of Africa. As you were watching, I was telling Pastor, this was a former Muslim. That was a former Muslim, and they are overseers of the great church of God in Chad, in Niger, in Mali, in Senegal. They were all former Muslims. Some of them were even prepared to be mullahs and imams. So nobody is beyond God's reach and God's love and God's redemption and God's salvation. This, and one of them, Brother Isaka, I showed you the picture. This brother from Niger, he has, among Muslims, he has started 57 house churches in Niamey, Niger. Praise God. It's just, and they are willing to put their life on the line for the gospel of Jesus Christ. That's why I'm going. That's why my wife is going and training. Long story short, guess what happened? The Lord gave me dreams and a vision. Amen. Long story short, one more time. Amen. Yeah, I know. I got your points now. And my wife already sick. My wife began to give me a paper, K-I-S-S. What does that mean? Keep it short, stupid. Amen. K-I-S-S, you know. Not keep it sweet, sweetie. No. Amen. But long story short, I promise you, is this. The Lord gave me a dream and a vision for 7 days and night. I couldn't sleep. I couldn't study. I couldn't even eat. I had no desire. And in my dream, this is the most powerful part. I saw two giants fighting. At the beginning, I thought of my free kung fu. Yeehaw! Hey-yah! Whatever, you know. Bruce Lee or Chuck Norris. I almost did it, you know. Sometimes I'll do something in the church, you know. But listen to this. But they were not kung fu. By the way, I used to be kung fu also. But now, too many junior bacon cheeseburger from Miss Wendy's. From Miss Wendy's. Now, there's not much kong with this fool. Amen. Not much kong with this fool. I'm a fool for Jesus. Amen. And even the foolishness of God is wiser than man's wisdom. Amen. And the Spirit of God touched me. I saw myself in the dream with those who were watching. And eventually, bloody, brutal fighting. And an evil giant out of the two. The evil giant was defeated and destroyed. And the victorious one rushed towards me and grabbed hold of me and calling me by name. Just like Isaiah 43 verse 1 says, "Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your own name, and you are mine." Praise God. And when he touched me, he held me up. All the others were running away. I could not run away. But he was calling by name and told me, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am Jesus Christ, your Lord. I was wounded for your transgression, and I was bruised for your iniquities. By my stripes, you are healed." I woke up shouting, praising God. And there were seven other people in the same dorm because there were four bunk beds, you know. They thought I was crazy. They thought I was going bananas, you know, like coming from the banana republics, you know what I mean? But the Spirit of God touched me. I couldn't even stop. And that's how it happened for a week or so. Until finally, as I was reading the manuscript, suddenly the Spirit of God came to me with conviction. Repent, 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 I heard. And I opened my manuscript that I was hiding, copied from the Bible, hiding, and one section touched me, just like my wife quoted from Romans chapter 10. Confess with your mouth Jesus Christ the Lord, but also don't pay God lip service. Some of us may be paying lip service to God for too long. Man, get real, amen, and do something with your faith, amen. Put some feet to your faith, for faith without work is what? Dead, and even deadly to us, you know. So I began to follow those few verses and repent of my sin. On my knees, I cried to God. And the moment I confessed my sin and repented according to what I saw, what I copied from Romans chapter 10, because that whosoever call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And Hong Yang was one of those whosoever's. Under the conviction of the Holy Spirit, that's how on my knees I received Jesus. And the moment I confessed my sin, the moment I asked him to forgive me, repent of myself, and he came into my heart, and it became my joy, my strength, and my salvation. And ever since December 83, my life has never been, and my life will never be the same anymore, because Jesus touched me, and Jesus made the difference in my heart. Put your hands together and praise the Lord. He touched me. He touched me, and all the joy that flooded my soul, and is still flowing and flooding my soul. Amen. Something happened, and now I know Jesus touched me and made me whole. Just like the song you sing, he fills you, he flows through you, and he even floods you. Fill you, flood you, and flow through you. FFF. That'll preach. Amen. And the Lord sent two Church of God people, professor from Lee College. You are talking about 33 years ago, man, 84. I met Dr. Sturkson and a wife, Carolyn, and they got to know me and found out who I was and began to disciple me and gave me a Bible when I was 21 years old. We're talking about fall 1984 when I met them 33 years ago. And I was filled with the Holy Spirit. And I was called to be a preacher, like your song said. I love this song. No turning back, no looking back. I thank you, Miss Wendy, for the two songs. Those are among my favorite. At the cross. Amen. And the other one, Oh Victory in Jesus. I sing them all the time. Amen. Praise God. Oh, those are among my favorites. Amen. The more I sing, just like you feel, the more I feel the joy. And the joy of the Lord is our strength. In his presence, either the fullness of joy and the joy of the Lord is our strength. How do you enter his presence? Through your praises and a song of praises. Because the Lord inhabits the praises of his people, and we are his people. Amen. Praise God. And the Spirit of God touched Dirksen's 1 year later now. Now it's summer 85. 32 years ago, gave me a scholarship. God is so loved, he gave. I'm convinced one can give without loving, but no one can truly love without giving. For God is so loved that he gave. One of my favorite verses is Galatians 2:20, where Paul said, I have been crucified together with Christ, and I no longer live. And the life I live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and who gave himself for me. Praise God. Love and give. And they gave to give me a scholarship, and I came by the miracle of God to the Church of God School of Theology. And the communists saw my word theology, and all of them translated as School of Technology. They had no idea what theology was, you know, being atheist communist, you know. And that's what the Bible says. The fool says in his heart, there is no God. So when you become an atheist, you also become very stupid. Right? and a fool. That's the truth, the Bible says. Listen, because they have no common sense anymore. And they thought of technology. So all of them translated. I was going to go to the School of Technology in Cleveland, Tennessee. Amen. And because I was going to study technology, of course, for once, I kept my big mouth shut also. Amen. Oh, praise God. I said, I will study very hard. I said, okay, you know, I'll study very hard. And they even gave me $2,700 to help me start it. Why? Why? Because you're going to study technology. We want you to pray about it. Think about coming back to China and teach in your humble alma mater university. I said, I will try. Guess what? $2,700. I never even had $70 in my life. 21 years old, but God provided wonderfully, and not only got my passport, got my visa, graduated August. By September 3rd, I was studying in the Church of God School of Technology. technology. Give the Lord praise, hallelujah. With communist money and communism give me the support to study the divine technology, the only one that can deliver soul from hell. Amen. And this is my story. And this is my song. That's another song that I love. Blessed Assurance. That's another one. I love it. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all day long. And I might as well say all night long. And I thank God for you. And with Pastor's permission, could I get a few people to help us, Pastor? If you could, yes. Let me have one. Can somebody help us, please? And your church is known as one of the strongest Pentecostal churches. And it was a great vision for missions, and I thank God for you. It's because of the wonderful spiritual leadership. I just learned 9 years now in this place, Sister Wendy and Pastor Odom. Let's give a kind of appreciation to the Odom family, Odom couple. I felt a kindred spirit with them 3 years ago, and I never stopped keeping in touch. Amen. You can run, but you can't hide now. Amen. No, seriously. And you give a generous support. I want to thank God for you and your humble spiritual leadership. I like that term, sacrificial spiritual leadership. That's what we promote everywhere we go. Not by talking, but by walking. Not by words, but indeed. To lead, to do it indeed, not just in word. Amen. And if you do it indeed, you got to get ready, because sometimes to weed, you got to bleed. And in this country that I mentioned to you, Northern Africa, we went in as living martyrs for Jesus Christ, knowing, and they told us, you could be martyred any time. 99.9% of Muslims, what do you expect? If you want to come, be ready just in case, because you are not going to be even the last one either. And surely not be the first one. Mali, Senegal, this is a Morocco. Pray for us. Turn with me to the first page. Everybody got a faith promise card? Please don't discard it, because this is Hong Yang American Express. Don't leave home without it. Amen. And through this practice of fundraising, faith promise, God has used us to raise, even by 5 years ago, over $10 million now for mission project. Now maybe 13 million, 12 million now. I don't know. But God is good. It's because of wonderful, great, godly people who are good, like you in Okoye Church of God. Turn with me to the first page. On the upper right corner, everybody got one? Who doesn't have it? On the upper right corner, he said, my gift today, whether it's $1 or $100, whether it's $10 or $20, whatever you can do, you know, you can write it down there, whether it's in cash, check, or credit card, write down also. And he said, then the amount selected below, you can consider to pay, and some of you can do it only once only, but I pray and hope. I'm not here to pressure you. Please don't be afraid. But shut the door. Nobody going until I raise $10,000. I'm joking. Paul Walker used to say that, you know. Lock the door. Nobody going until I raise $10,000 today, you know. I was in a Spanish service where literally had to take 7 offerings to meet a budget in San Francisco. And of course, it's not hateful. It's joyful singing again. And the overseer, 100. Then the second, they did raise it over $5,000. They had to. I think among Caucasian American like you guys would be offended, but Latinos, no problem. Yes, more of a joyful thing. And they wouldn't go until they raised 7 times in the Church of God temple in Oakland, California. So I'll never be with Carlos Moran, you know. But I'm not going to do that to you. But I don't believe even in compulsion, because, or even in any manipulation, coercion, only by conviction from the heart and because of compassion in the soul. God has touched that. You know, and I thank God, whatever you can do, we receive with deep gratitude, because this is not doing it for our mission, Africa, China, Church of God, woman, it's for Jesus. I like what Mother Teresa always says at the end when she makes a appeal, would you do something for Jesus today? That truly captures what a mission is all about. Jesus. It's not about a denomination, it's not about a church, it's not about a nation, it's about souls for Jesus' reason. For the sake of Jesus, would you do something? So you can do something once, but I'm praying and hoping, those of you who have a regular source of income, could you do something? Is that monthly? Mark monthly, weekly, monthly, mark monthly. By faith, I'll give $10 a month. By faith, I'm giving $30 a month. Whatever you can do, I hope I can recruit and enlist some workers of the vineyard who can do something regularly. You may not be able to give $100 or $50, but if you give $5, $10, it adds up to $60 or $120, you see? Right. So I'm not here to ask you to do something that's not reasonable. And we're doing it together. Always support the missions ourselves. And then give us your credit card information if you want to do it by credit card. That's fine too. So many are doing it. Then give us name and address. Let me give you the project number. Anybody ready to write? Who needs a pen? I got even an extra pen stolen from the AM service. Amen? Stolen from the AM service. Church of God in Clearwater. Anybody need? No? Okay. Yeah. Project number is 060. Yeah, you write it down in the lower right corner. Anywhere, lower right corner, you see the space there? Yeah, 060. Yeah, if you can. Dash 0036. Just anywhere here will be okay. Yeah, lower right corner line. 060-0036. That's been our project number. We don't fly by the night. Even though we might have to drive by the night sometime. But we've been doing this for 28 years now. Since we were sworn in, Church of God missionaries never looked back. God has been faithful. Started out Latin American mission, learned Spanish, preached all over Latin America. Even a second daughter born there as we were living in Puerto Rico, then through there, Lima, Peru, Argentina, you name it. Just awesome. Chinese, Southern, Hillbilly, Latino. That's what Hong Yang is. I'm a Chinese, Southern, Hillbilly, Latino. Amen. Praise God. I preached a Spanish service today from 2 to 4. Amen. Then I realized I had to come here, which takes about 2 hours. Had to rush. So 8 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 6 o'clock. I hope there is somewhere about a 10 o'clock p.m. service. We can know. But I might be like Paul preaching one to death in the book of Acts. And I don't know what have the healing power to raise from the dead. You know, Paul did that. Maybe he became too long-winded. Send then, tear the last page. This is your receipt, last page. And a reminder, said donor, last page, tear it down. Yeah, and let me give you the project number again. Some of you, I know you didn't write it down. If you want to write it down, 060, let me say it again, 060-0036. Got it. Amen. 060-0036 in the lower right corner. Tear the last page and then put the white and the yellow copy in the offering plate. If it's a check, make it payable. Is that okay, Pastor, for the local church? Then, as you have done generously last time, church will write one check to world missions. And 100% of what you give will go to where you want it to go. And we'll give you a receipt and thank you letter. And I'm always in touch with Pastor Odom and all the pastors. I'm in touch. I like to keep in touch. Amen. So I thank you and God bless you for your kingdom investment. You are strategic, generous investors, not just a passive, mere contributors. I want to tell you, and great shall be your reward, because those who invest will have the great impact. And I thank God for you. Thank you, Pastor, for this opportunity. Let's praise the Lord as Pastor come and receive for Jesus. Amen.
Have you enjoyed Dr. Hong Yang tonight? Amen. What a blessing. Sister Wendy, if you'll come, let me just help you with some instructions. If you're giving your offering tonight, it goes in the upper right hand corner. Make sure you put, if you're putting five or 500 or 5,000, it goes in the upper right hand corner. If 5,000 would be better. If you are not, if you're giving tonight, you will put it in the upper right-hand corner. If you're giving tonight and also want to give monthly, or you're going to only give monthly, then you fill out the part below that. Make sure you have your name and things of that nature. And then we'll take what is given tonight, the cash and the checks. Make your checks payable to Ocoee Church. Sister Myra already knows. We'll roll all that up into one check, and he'll leave with one check as opposed to a bunch of checks and cash for safety purposes, okay? All right? Everybody clear? All right? If you have any questions, we'll help you. All right? Ushers, won't you come on down to the front, and let's get ready to receive this offering. And then following this offering, our finance staff will go ahead and take care of that and help us with that. We can make sure we get that for Brother Dr. Hong Yang tonight. What a joy it is to have him back with us and all the good things. And if you didn't pick up on what he said, when he was here 3 years ago, he had informed us that he was banned from China, basically. They did not approve his visa, and his visa still has not been approved, and that's why Sister Esther has to go and take care of that there. But why? Ain't God doing some wonderful things through their ministry? Amen. I believe he has some pictures that are on the altars. He has some books that he has written that are available. So what we're going to do is we're going to receive the offering. After all of that is done, I'll dismiss in prayer,
And then if you want to come up and fellowship with them, I know they'll be delighted to do that. Let us pray together for offering. Father, thank you for the ministry tonight. Thank you for what you've done across this campus and, Lord, in this sanctuary. I pray as we come to this offering, that you'll bless it, Lord. Let the gifts tonight and the continual gifts for the next year, Lord, let it just make a difference in the ministries, Lord, that Dr. Yang has presented to us tonight. Thank you for missions. Thank you for the Church of God. And we'll forever be grateful for it. In the name of Jesus we pray. And everybody said amen and amen. Just wrap that up. Put it all in the offering plate. And they'll sort it out in the office in a little bit.
There's a call come ringing over the restless waves.
Send the line. Send the line.
There are souls to rescue. There are souls to save.
Send the light. Send the light. Send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine from shore to shore. Send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine forevermore. Send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine forevermore. Oh, send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine forevermore.
We have heard the Macedonian call today.
Send the light, send the light.
And a golden offering at the cross we lay.
Send the light, send the light. Send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine from shore to shore. Send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine forevermore. Send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine from shore to shore. Send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine forevermore. Oh, send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine from shore to shore. Send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine.
Oh, sing it one more time tonight, church.
Oh, send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine from shore to shore. Send the light, the blessed gospel light. Let it shine forevermore.
Would you stand with me across the building tonight? We're going to pray a prayer of dismissal, and after that, if you'll come up and fellowship with Dr. and Sister Yang and all of the pitchers, and I'm so thankful that they were able to be with us tonight. Father, we love you tonight. Thank you for all that you've done for us. Just pray that you'll move, Lord, on this ministry. Let it continue to make differences in lives around the world. Bless Dr. Yang and Sister Esther, Lord, as they move forward in your calling. We'll forever give you praise for it. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Everybody said amen and amen. God bless you tonight.